couple of words. You, how about these brand new suits, huh? I know people have told you this, but the last, these last 28 years, we'd like these to last at least that long. So please, and I know it's hard, I'm catching myself in it all the time, keep your feet off the seats.
Yes.
That means off the back, so that means you get all scuffed up. And you don't want the smell of someone else's foot lingering in the front of your seat. So. Also, please don't chew gum in here. If there's gum in your mouth, keep it there or swallow it. But don't stick it anywhere, throw it on the floor, and absolutely no food. Also, this is a very special performance. So the sound carries really well in here. So especially those of you in the back who think you can't be heard, actually you can be heard really well. There's a sweet spot back there that carries straight up here. So please don't whisper, talk. You're free to respond and laugh and applaud and stuff, and you'll want to. This is the culmination of what we're calling Clown College in the advanced drama classes. And we had another teacher in here a couple of weeks ago, Gail McNeely. This week we've been just really treated to have a professional movement artist named James Donlon. James is a very special person. He describes himself as a neoclassic clown. Now, when we think of clowns in our culture, we often think of circus clowns, like Barnum and Bailey clowns. Now, while James has done that and actually has trained clowns for the Barnum and Bailey Circus, it's a neoclassic clown is so much more. In his own words, it means it's a theater artist who's free to use any means possible to communicate. So James has done a whole bunch of things in the last 40 years. For the last 35 years, he's toured his act internationally, all over the world. He has worked with the actors Benjamin Bratt and Kathy Bates in major Hollywood films. He's trained circus clowns for Barnum and Bailey. He's taught at the Yale School of Drama, the Alabama Shakespeare Festival, the American Conservatory Theater in San Francisco, the North Carolina School of the Arts, and most recently at the University of California, Santa Barbara, where actually James had his own troupe, and they've been working. He works in LA and Mexico, and he's produced works with his troupe that explore issues of immigration, power, and gender identification. He's a local treasure, he's a brilliant artist, and I know you're going to enjoy him. Please give a big hand for James Donlon.
Thank you.
I Hey, Push it back in. Boom. So, nothing there. just air. So you have to be in good shape, you have to be flexible, you have to have a good imagination, and you can use these techniques to your advantage. Like, here's an idea. If you take some space and make a line, a very thin line, I can change it in the air. I'll make it a little thicker. Then I can start pushing on it, maybe. Pulling. Moving it around. Oops! You can bend it. Let's see, let's put it around here. So, here, pass it.
Thank you.
stage and when the vision goes on the stage. So once you're kind of attuned to the style, you can see what's happening. Okay? So that's called a classic mind. Next thing I'm going to do is based on my circus experience. I'm going to change costumes. So I have some circus clown shoes here. Now, about 19, see, this is hard work. Sweat. This is got to be in shape. So about 1974, I was a clown trainer at Ringling Brothers Circus. So at that time I lived in San Francisco. And so I was hired by the circus to go to Florida for 3 months every fall for 2 years. And my job was to be the physical trainer for the clowns. At that time there was no Cirque du Soleil. You know, how many people have seen Cirque du Soleil? So that's a very enjoyable kind of circus, but it's very different than the traditional circus. The traditional circus, especially in America, has animals, and you have lion tamers, and it's not so theatrical, it's not so surreal, much more traditional. That's where you get the clowns, you might call them bozos. You know, you have a big red nose and the hair. Sometimes they do wear shoes like this, but this is a shoe like this is more traditional. So even Cirque du Soleil clowns will wear shoes like this. And one of the reasons, anybody have an idea why there's a long shoe like that? Do I have a theory on that? Huh? Guess what? Yeah, I put it on right. No, I didn't. Anybody have a theory on that? True, but why would I want to do that? Why would I want to distort my feet? What's that?
The elephant
couldn't step on it. The elephant couldn't step on it? Well, I think it would if it's bigger, wouldn't it?
But then it's on your foot. It's the
big foot. Ah, okay. So is that a funny moment? Is that a funny moment? Would that be funny?
Yeah. I love it.
I guess it's not this one. Right. So the long shoe is to create an otherworldly effect. And to accentuate a part of the body, all right? So the clown is not a real person in some ways very real, and that's the key. It's like poetry, you know? Poetry seems to be something different than prose, and yet poetry can be very deep and powerful. Well, the same thing with the clown. The clown has a particular aesthetic that's a little bit surreal, a little bit poetic, but then some of the feelings that come out can be very, very, very strong. It doesn't have to be funny, necessarily. Okay, this next thing I'm going to do is based on my circus experience. Okay? And I'm having real trouble with this. Here we go. This piece is called Acrobats. And originally it was a dream. I had a dream. And I woke up the next morning, and the dream was about the craziness of the circus. And so I woke up the next morning and I went into the practice studio and I did this once and it stayed this way for 30 years. So the material I'm doing in the beginning of the show is a little older, and then some of the material at the end of the show will be stuff I created last year, for example. All right. So this is called Acrobats. It takes me about 30 seconds to put on a piece of clothing, and this is the expression, or you might say it's my mind thinking about the circus. Okay, so one moment.
Thank you.
like a painter or a musician to create the sense of a circus, even though, you know, you're not, you know, we didn't have a high wire here for the acrobats. Okay, good. Okay, now I'm going to show you something that I created last year. All right, let me put this off to the side here. This one's called Today is Now. And it's basically some thoughts that I have about our culture today, our society, that affects people. See what you make of it, okay? Because I think there's a social message here in this one, all right? And you tell me at the end what you think. Get my red sneakers back on. Today is now. Thank you. drunk. What's that about? It's about drugs, but in part, but not just drugs. It could be about alcohol, it could be about the internet, could be about television, could be about eating a lot of donuts. Okay? So why would I, what happened if it's about, you know, those kinds of things? What happened? It's about hiding from your problems and not trying to solve them. That's exactly right. That's exactly what my intention was. You know, like today in our world, a lot of times people are bored. They give themselves quick fixes, you know, with material things, and then suddenly their body starts to break down. It could be about stress. You know, it could be about a lifestyle. And then in the end, nobody comes to their assistance very often in our culture. You know, you end up needing help, and a lot of times people don't help. So that's exactly right. Anybody else have a comment about that? So this is not classic mind. This is called neoclassic. So you're using some of the classic techniques, but treating a contemporary idea. And in some senses, no matter what you do, is always contemporary. Because if you hit the themes right, they're timeless stories. Those of you that studied Shakespeare or great novels or great paintings, the themes continue out through history. All right? Okay, let's go back to the clown character for a minute. Shut up! Je la pique! Je la mire! Rafati! Caradou! Thank you. To find you.
Cool, dude!
Hey, the camera! Hey! Thank you! For you! Go get him, cowboy! For a while. I'll be back in a while. ugly mom. He says he realized that shooting is not a game. That's true also. Yes. Right. Right. It's kind of an abstract, it's like poetry again, right? He becomes the bird. He kind of fulfills life itself. Going back to his mom. What's interesting about this piece is my actual mother, my mother died about 3 months before I made this. So when I was doing it, that sometimes I'd be doing it, I don't think that way now, but sometimes I'd be doing it, I'm going, wow, am I taking on the spirit of my mother? What's going on here? It was very psychological in a way. But all three of them are right. You know, it's really about that event in my life told me something about death. It also made me appreciate life, and it really happened to me. So it's like writing a story, writing a poem, writing a piece of music about something that you felt in your life, and then you communicate it as an artist. So, who has a question? Because we're just about done. Who has a question about anything? Yes? How long did it take? Well, I've been doing this, I started learning in about 1969. And I'm still learning, all right? But you have to put a lot of training into it. Like, I was an athlete before that. I was a high school basketball player. I also played college basketball. In fact, right now, one of the things I do is I'm a basketball coach at Santa Barbara High School. I was at Santa Marcos, so we've actually played your team before. But I know what it takes to be a good athlete. It takes a lot of hard work. You have to put the same energy into this kind of thing. You know, you have to work at it. You have to stay in shape. Like, how old do you think I am?
19.
No, honestly. Huh?
City! Maybe
45.
Right. Anyway. Okay. Like I'll be 60 next year. So this takes. You have to stay in shape. Okay. Like I can't. Some of it's harder for me to do than it was years ago. But do this kind of work. You have to stay in shape. You have to stay limber. You have to stay alert in your brain. It's a great exercise to do for an older person. Okay. And an older person. Any other questions? Any other questions? Did you enjoy it?
Let's give it up one more time for James. It's a real treat.
Thank you. just doing it.
Okay, I know I'm looking like I'm busy, but I'm not.
Maybe Michelle wanted a ride. Dan wants a ride.
Okay.
Our will probably crush him.